a 100 on a test. Maybe you pass by the gas station. You buy a lotto ticket. You pick the winning numbers. Then you get to work, and the boss said, "Hey, I noticed that your performance review and that report you left on my desk last week were absolutely stellar, and so you're long overdue for a promotion and a 50% raise. Congratulations." And it just keeps going on like that.
Space where life consists of putting one foot in front of the other, not
going horribly wrong, but nothing out of the ordinary is going wonderfully either. It just feels like we're putting our noses to the grindstone, we're working, we're playing, we're living, we're taking care of the children, we're taking care of the parents, we're washing the dishes. You get the idea. But perhaps it's in those moments that the spiritual fruit is actually most closely within our grasp. I remember my experience of clinical pastoral education. It was the hot, hot summer, of course every summer down in Austin, Texas is a hot, hot summer, of 2009. I was assigned to Seton Memorial Hospital, and I was assigned to the main one, which was also the Level 1 Trauma Center. So it gave lots of opportunity for pretty extreme ministry. I could spend all day, every day, if I so desired, dealing with people who were either on cloud 9 or in the depths of despair and knocking on death's door. And I found myself very attracted to that, and this was something that did not escape the notice of my supervisor. And she laid upon me a challenge that at the time had me wanting to wring her neck. And she said, Annie, for the next 2 weeks, I want you to respond to none of the extreme calls. When they call a code gray, in the hospital means like police show up with their guns drawn, something's really going down, don't go. When they call a code anything, in fact, don't go, because that's one of those extreme cases. Either somebody is utterly jubilant or in serious, serious trouble. So I want you to go to the rooms that are kind of quiet. The people that obviously are in need of something, because otherwise they wouldn't